So performance measures, when we talk about measuring performance, we discuss that in order to measure any performance or any portfolio manager's skill, there are two things that we look at. We look at return and we look at risk, and then we compare return with risk. Okay. So in order to measure performance, we compare return with risk. And when we talk about return, we also discuss that only looking at portfolio return is not enough. You need to compare portfolio return with another return, with a target, with a benchmark or whatever. So in order to analyze performance, or in order to analyze any portfolio's performance or portfolio manager's skill, what we do is we compare the portfolio return with the benchmark return. So we set a benchmark and then we compare the portfolio's return with the benchmark return. If portfolio is generating a higher return compared to benchmark, that is good. If portfolio is generating a lower return, that means portfolio is underperforming the benchmark. So for example, if your benchmark is stock market, so for example, you have taken S&P 500 index as your benchmark for US stock market. So if your portfolio gives a higher return compared to this, then that will be considered as a better performance. If your portfolio gives a lower return, then that will be considered as an underperformance or a poor performance compared to benchmark. Any confusion so far? So that means anyone can just replicate benchmark and make as much return as benchmark provides. So if I am any investor, what I can do is I can invest it directly into S&P 500 index, which is a benchmark, and I can get as much return as it makes. If I am giving my money to a portfolio manager or to an investment manager, then I expect some return above the benchmark return, because benchmark is something which I can make myself. I already have the market portfolios available. I can just replicate a portfolio and make the same return as that portfolio. If I am giving my investment or my funds to a portfolio manager, then I expect him or her to make a higher return. So that means portfolio manager's skill will be reflected in the difference between portfolio return and benchmark return. That is the value being added by portfolio manager or the portfolio. So the difference between portfolio return and benchmark return is known as active return. This is the return due to active management. If anyone is managing portfolio passively, they can still earn benchmark return. What they earn above benchmark is due to active management. That is active return. And also, this is also known as value added. So value added or active return is the difference between portfolio return and benchmark return. Any problem so far? So if benchmark gave you 10%, portfolio gave you 15%, that means 5% is due to value addition or active return. Any problem? Confusion? So next question is that how do you decide this benchmark? This can be anything. So how do you decide it? What should be the qualities of this particular benchmark? When you are choosing a benchmark, what qualities should you look at? So some qualities to look at include: benchmark should be representative of assets from which investor will select. So let's say that investor's portfolio is invested, or investor is investing its portfolio in consumer sector only. So benchmark should also be of consumer sector. If you take benchmark as financial sector, then that will be wrong. Why? Because your portfolio includes some assets from some other industry and your benchmark is from some other industry. So benchmark should have the same, should be representative of the same assets as what investor holds in its, in his or her portfolio. If let's say investor is investing into US, then your benchmark also needs to be from US stocks. If let's say investor is investing into bonds, then your benchmark also needs to be of bond. If investor is investing into high quality bonds, then benchmark should also be from high quality bond. If investor is investing into low quality bonds, benchmark should also be from low quality bonds. Otherwise, these two will not be comparable. So that is one key point to remember. Second is positions in benchmark portfolio can actually be replicated at low cost. That means whatever you have in benchmark, investor or anyone should be able to buy it or should be able to sell it. If you keep some assets in benchmark which cannot be bought or sold, then it is useless. Why? Because if investor cannot or portfolio manager cannot buy or sell them, then that should not be a criteria for judging his or her performance. And weights are verifiable extensive means that weights of the benchmark should be known in advance. Why? Because once time period has passed, then you can adjust weights or portfolio manager can adjust weights of the benchmark to show a better performance. So weights should be decided in advance. Weights of benchmark should be known in advance. So for example, if you have a benchmark X within which you have bonds and equity. Let's say bonds is 40% and equity is 60%. So this should be known in advance. You should know at the start of selecting benchmark that these are the weights in benchmark. Any problem? Okay, so this is your active return which we have already discussed. If you calculate portfolio return and subtract benchmark return, that will give you active return. Now the question is, where does this active return come from? So there are two sources of this active return. Asset allocation and security selection. So let's say you have a benchmark B and a portfolio P. In benchmark, you can have securities A and B. A has a weight of 40%. B has a weight of 60%. So your portfolio's return will only be different if either your weights are different or your securities are different. If I take A again here, B here, 40% and 60%, both will give me exactly the same return. So that means value will either come in if I change the weights, for example, to maybe 50 and 50, then the return on portfolio will be different. Or if I change the securities, that is instead of B, I take C. So that means value or added value or the active return will be generated, can be generated due to two reasons or through two strategies, by either changing the weight or changing the security. Any problem? So you either change the asset or you change the weight. So the return will change. If it is due to changing weight, that is known as return, active return due to asset allocation. And if it is due to changing security, for example, taking C instead of B, then that is known as active return due to change in security. And these two combined or added or the sum of these two should give you the active return. Any problem? So there are two sources of active return, asset allocation and security selection. And the sum of these two should give you the total active return. Any questions, problems? So it will either come due to active weights or it will come from active returns. Active weights or active returns. What is active weight? Just like active return is portfolio return minus benchmark return. Similarly, active weights are portfolio weight minus benchmark weight. And similarly, active risk would be the standard deviation of this return that we will move on to later. So active weight is portfolio weight minus benchmark weight, and active return is portfolio return minus benchmark return. Any problem? Confusion? So what is active weight? Active weight is portfolio weight minus benchmark weight. If weight in portfolio is higher, then we call it overweight. If weight in portfolio is lower, we will call it underweight compared to benchmark. So here is a table. These are benchmark weights and these are portfolio weights. And this is the return. So you have to tell which countries are overweight against the benchmark. So overweight will be the one which have higher weight compared to benchmark. So which one is the overweight? UK is overweight. Underweight. So overweight is Germany. Only Germany. And which ones are underweight? UK, Japan, and France. Any problem? So if securities are exactly the same, then these changes in weight would result in changes in portfolio return. So for example, I assume that securities are exactly the same and only difference is the weights. And what is that? That is active weight. And what are the active weights? Active weight is portfolio weight minus benchmark weight. So how much will this active weight be? This and so on. So you can calculate it by just subtracting benchmark weight from portfolio weight. So if you are asked about the active weights, you can simply calculate it by taking the difference. Any problem? Now the question, next question is that how much extra return or how much extra active return would be generated due to these changes in weight. So simply what you can do is you can take active weight and multiply with the return for that year. So if you multiply each active weight with the respective return, that will give you the respective active returns. That is the extra return or loss which you are making due to change in weight. Any problem so far? So what will it be? What's the answer to minus 6 into 20.7? Yeah. So minus 6 into 20.7 minus 7 into 27.3 minus 2 into 27.7, 15 into 32.4 and 0 into 18.8. So if you multiply all of these, you will get the individual active returns. And if you are calculating active return for the overall portfolio, it should be the sum of all of these. So if you sum them up, that should give you the total value added or active return. So what's the answer? Any problems? Well, if you round it off, it will be 1. So we discussed that there are two sources of value added: asset allocation and security selection. Asset allocation is due to change in weights And so how do we calculate this part of value added? This part of value added is change in weight multiplied by return on benchmark. Just like we did in the previous question. We took active weights and we multiplied active weight with benchmark return. That was the value added due to asset allocation. Any problem? Confusion? And if I have to calculate value added due to security selection, that will be opposite of it. That will be security return minus security return in benchmark, which is the active return of security, multiplied by weight of benchmark. So if you are calculating value added due to weights, you take change in weight into benchmark return. If you are calculating value added due to security selection, you take change in return of security multiplied by weight of benchmark. And if you add them, that will be the total value added. So total value added will be the sum of this part and this part. Or it will be equal to portfolio return minus return on benchmark. Any problem? So far what we did in the previous example was value added due to asset allocation, in which we were keeping different weights. So this part, change in weight multiplied by benchmark return is due to asset allocation. Change in return multiplied by portfolio weight is due to security selection. So remember this formula, that if you take change in weight and multiply it by the return benchmark, that is value added due to asset allocation. If you take change in return and multiply it with the weight of portfolio, that gives you value added due to security selection. And if you add them up, that is the total active return or value added. Any problem? Okay, next question is, you have three funds. This is the fund return and this is the benchmark return. What will be the value added? Value added is simply portfolio return minus benchmark return. So for first fund, value added will be 3%. For second fund, it will be minus 1.9 minus minus 2, which is 0.1. And for third one, it will be 4.8. So if you have to calculate value added for these funds, simply what you can do is you can take portfolio return and subtract benchmark return. So this will be the value added for first portfolio, this will be the value added for second, this is the value added for third portfolio. Now if you have weights, you can multiply these by weights to get the total value added. But so far we do not have any weights, we are assuming that all these three are different funds and different portfolios. Any problem? Next question is that you are making a portfolio. For that portfolio, you are investing 68% in Fidelity fund. So 68% in this fund and 32% in PIMCO and 0% in third one. So this has been, this is the total portfolio, the sum combination of these two. So you are investing 68% in Fidelity You are investing 32% in PIMCO. And you are asked what is the value added due to security selection. So remember, when we do it for asset allocation, formula is change in weight multiplied by return on benchmark. And when we do it for security selection, formula is change in return or active return multiplied by weight in portfolio. So here you are asked about security selection. So which formula should I choose? First one or second one? Second one. Which is active return into weight. So what is the active return for Fidelity? 3%. That is 35.3 minus 32.3. So what we do is, we take this active return and we multiply it with the weight. And we take second active return and we again multiply it with the weight. We do it for all, sum them up, and that will be the value added due to security selection. So if I multiply 3 into 6.68%, what is the answer? Sorry? 2.04. And 0.1 into 32%? Sorry? 0.3 should be. 0.032%. And if I sum them up, that will be the total value added due to security selection. So how much is the value added due to security selection? 2.1%. So that means for security selection, for value added due to security selection, you take change in return, which is active return, and you multiply it with the weight in portfolio. You do it for all the assets and sum them up. But when we are talking about asset allocation, you take change in weight and multiply with that with the return on benchmark. Any problem? So this is due to security selection. Now next question is, assume that investors' strategic asset allocation specifies 60% equity and 40% bond. That means benchmark is 60% equity, 40% bonds. This is your benchmark. However, he has invested 68% in equity and 32% in bond. So benchmark weights are 60 and 40, but portfolio weights are 68 and 32. And this is Fidelity and this is PIMCO. Any problem? And you have to calculate active return due to asset allocation. So formula for active return due to asset allocation or value added due to asset allocation is change in weight multiplied by return on benchmark. So difference in weight will be 68 minus 68%, and 32 minus 40, which is minus 8%. Any problem? And then what you need to do is you need to multiply change in weight with the benchmark return. So your benchmark return for Fidelity is 32.3. So multiplied by 32.3%. And your benchmark return for PIMCO is minus 2. So you multiply it by minus 2 percent. And if you sum them up, that will be the value added due to asset allocation. So as long as you know the difference between asset allocation and security selection, you should be able to find out the component of asset allocation and component of security selection in value addition. So what's the answer? 2.74%. So weight, new portfolio weight minus benchmark weight multiplied by benchmark return. And similarly, portfolio weight again minus benchmark weight multiplied by benchmark return, 2.7%. Remember, this is not total value added, this is value added due to asset allocation. Value added due to security selection was 2.1. So if you have both the components, if you know what is value added due to security selection, that is 2.4. If you know what is value added due to asset allocation, which is 2.7, then what should be the total value added? Total value added should be the sum of these two, which is 5.1%. Any questions? This is 2.1, sorry. So 2.1, 2.7, it is 4.8%. Any problem? And simply if I just take the active returns and sum them up, that is also 4.8%. If I have to break down this into two components, then one is security selection and one is asset allocation. Otherwise, if I have to calculate total, simply I can also take fund return, total portfolio return, and subtract total benchmark return. Any questions, problems?